Did you guys come from San Diego today?
Yeah. Oh, we drove last night.
Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right. Do you go often to San Diego?
I do. I do. I love it. My mom still lives there, so I go down there a lot. And our little boys have doctors down there and stuff, so we take them down to get their physicals and everything. Stay in Mission Valley, and you know, there's too many of us to move into the old house, so my mom's place in Fashion Valley is pretty full, but so it's great. I love it. San Diego's so great.
Oh, it's beautiful.
The
yeah,
best.
I'm from Mexico. I moved to San Diego in 2005.
Oh, wow.
And just to go to school.
Where in Mexico?
I was born in Torreón, Coahuila, but I grew up in Sonora.
Cool,
very
man.
Very close to the border in Arizona.
Excellent.
So, yeah, I just, you know, wanted to do the radio and television department after the college and stayed in San Diego.
Yeah, man. So good.
I'm ready. I'm rolling.
Okay.
Now, do you want me to do I look at you? Do you want me to look in the camera? Do you want me to repeat the question and the answer?
If you want to repeat the question, you don't have to do it exactly.
Okay.
You just, you know.
All right.
And they're exactly the same questions that I
thank you.
So, yeah. We can start off with, why did you college in the first place?
I have to make sure my fashion is working here because I'm such a fashion plate. I almost came in shorts, but I figured respect for City College. Come on.
And flip-flops.
And flip-flops, which of course would be accurate to the San Diego experience.
Right.
But mind frame, everything cool?
Everything's good. I'm rolling.
I'm so much more comfortable on the other side of the camera. I'm like, but anyway, I'm honored to talk to you about City.
Why did you choose City in the first place? Why did you even go there?
City College is a really kind of powerful place that's a beautiful secret in San Diego. Its location's amazing. It's unpretentious and very soulful. And I love the teachers, my mom being one of them. So I came to meet some of the teachers when I was starting to write. And I'd left San Diego for a little bit to go kind of journey with Rolling Stone as a reporter, and then came back home and wanted to pick up my college experience. And so I immediately felt like City College would be the greatest place. I knew some of the teachers from my mom, having been a teacher there for a long time. Larry Schwartz was a history teacher that I loved. And Hope Shaw was the head of the telecommunications department. And Hope Shaw was a big influence, and not just to me, to many people that I've, you know, met later and talked to about City College. But Hope Shaw was a very nurturing person, and telecommunications kind of encompassed all the stuff that I was interested in, which was like writing, doing something for film, doing something for video, music. It was kind of all combined into this group that said the future to me. And she really was kind of a steward of all that was going to come, I think, with greater emphasis on telecommunications, and visual arts, and she was completely inspiring and property of City College, so I was happy to go there.
Take me back to when you were
mm-hmm.
Well,
going to City was cool because you're basically near Balboa Park, you're near downtown, and here was the greatest thing. City College had a radio station, and it was a jazz radio station, but it was a radio station that broadcast, and you could pick it up on your car radio or your home radio, and it was like there was an opportunity to kind of play records. So I wasn't big into jazz, but Hope Shaw said, you know, there's a little period of time in Sunday night, or maybe it was Friday night. She said, there's a little window where we play non-jazz stuff. So if you want to go there and play some rock music, which I know you like, you can broadcast from our radio station. So I was so excited about that. I told my sister, you know, I'm going to be a DJ. and tune in at such and such a time. I'm going to play some records you've never heard before. And I had a copy of Led Zeppelin 4, which had come out not too much. I think Led Zeppelin 4 had probably come out about 3 months before Hope Shaw said go on the radio. And I was infatuated with the song Stairway to Heaven, which sort of hadn't caught on yet, you know. So my big thing is I wanted to go on the City College radio station, disrupt their jazz, and play Stairway to Heaven, which I did. And I remember being in the little cubicle down there and, you know, watching this song spin on the turntable, and the song was going on and on and on, and it was so long. And, like, jazzy guys are coming by going, what is this? I mean, length is okay when it's Coltrane, but Led Zeppelin? Come on. My sister was at home listening, and it was really, it was a big step in the path of loving rock and knowing you could do something more than just sit at home and listen. You could actually be active, be a DJ, or ultimately...
I'm going to go to the next one.